This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the triangle midsegment theorem. So here's what that theorem says. The midsegment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to and is half as long as the third side. So I've drawn a triangle here. I've labeled it ABC. And I've marked two points, point D and point E. Point D is a midpoint on side AB. So it cuts AB into two segments of equal length. And point E is a midpoint on side AC. So it also divides side AC into two segments of equal length. If I connect points D and E, I have what's called a midsegment. And this theorem says that that midsegment is parallel to the third side. It's parallel to BC, and it's one half as long as BC. So let's see if we can prove that. I'm going to start out by trying to show that triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. So here's how I'll do that. I'm going to look for the proportions for two pairs of corresponding sides. Well, if I look at side AD and its corresponding side AB, I see that AB is twice as long as AD. So that means the ratio of AD to AB is 1/2. And if I do the same thing for another pair of corresponding sides, AE and AC, I see that they also have a ratio of 1/2. So now I know I have two pairs of corresponding sides that are proportional. They've got the same ratio. The only other thing I have to do is show that I have two included angles that are congruent. Well, my included angles are going to be angle A and angle A, because both triangles share angle A. So I've got two pairs of sides that are proportional and a pair of included angles, that's angle A and angle A, that are congruent. So therefore, I've got two similar triangles. Once I know I have two similar triangles, I can label other parts of the triangle that are congruent. So angle B is going to be congruent to its corresponding angle ADE. And angle C is going to be congruent with its corresponding angle AED. And now I want to show that DE is parallel to BC. Well, if I think of AB as a transversal, then that transversal forms two corresponding angles. It forms angle B and angle ADE. Those corresponding angles are congruent. Therefore, DE and BC must be parallel lines, which is what the theorem said would happen. The theorem also said that DE was going to be half as long as BC. Well, that makes sense because the ratio of ADE to ABC, the ratio for all the sides, the proportion, was 1/2. So DE must be half as long as BC. Okay, so that's the midsegment theorem. Once again, what it says is this. If you've got a triangle and you've got two sides with midpoints, and you connect those midpoints, the midsegment that you've just made by connecting the midpoints is going to be parallel to the third side, and it will be half as long as the third side. There's another theorem that kind of goes along with this one, and here's what it says. If a line bisects one side of a triangle and is parallel to a second side, then it bisects the third side and is therefore a midsegment. So let's see what this means. I've got triangle ABC, and I've marked point D as a point that bisects side AB. And I've drawn line D, I'll label it DE. It's going to be parallel to BC, this side down here at the base. What this theorem says is that this point E would have to be a midpoint for side AC, that line DE must bisect side AC. And therefore, if I have two midpoints, that DE must be a midsegment. So we'll prove that pretty much the same way we proved the other one. I'm going to show that triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. I've got two parallel lines, so I'm going to mark the corresponding angles, angle B and angle ADE, as being congruent. Angle C corresponds to angle AED, so they're congruent also. So now I've got two triangles with two pairs of corresponding angles. If that's the case, those two triangles are similar. So triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. Now, I know that D is a bisector of AB, which means I've got two equal segments over here, AD and DB, or that AD is one half of AB. I should have the same ratio over here on line side AE and AC, so AE should be one half as long as AC. If that's the case, they would both AE and EC would have to be the same length. If they're the same length, then point E is a midpoint and line DE is a bisector. Okay, so if I've got two midpoints and a line connecting them, then that's a midsegment. So DE is a midsegment. And we can also say that DE must be half as long as BC from what we learned in the with the midsegment theorem. Okay, so once again, this theorem says that if I've only got one midpoint, but I've got a line that's parallel to a second side, that line is going to intersect the third side at its midpoint, and therefore will bisect that side and form a midsegment. Okay, so that's it. Take care. I'll see you next time.